It's a beautiful day in Wichita, Kansas. I'm Blaze Webster, and I'm right here by the historic Orpheum Theater. It was built in 1922. At its peak, it was this luxurious movie palace of the 30s and 40s. At its worst, it was a deteriorating shell of its former glory in the 70s. But in the 1980s, things changed, and now it's one of the most cherished pieces of Wichitan culture. The beauty of the Orpheum is that it survived. It survived many years of, you know, just crumbling infrastructure and just a lot of weird things that were happening, a lot of closings. And, you know, that's a luxury that the vast majority of theaters around Wichita that have ever been built, you know, have not had. Most of them have since been demolished. So over the course of this video, we're going to start on the east side of town. We're going to focus mainly not on theaters like the Orpheum that are, you know, older. We're going to focus more on theaters that are a bit more in recent memory. So, you know, I want this to be kind of a nostalgia trip for anybody watching, just to be able to point at it and be like, oh yeah, I remember that. So we're going to start on the east side, and then we're going to head over to some theaters downtown, and then to the west side, and it's going to be an amazing ride. So if you frequent the North Rock area, you've probably at least once driven past this building right here. It's kind of a wonky looking office building. Well, this is the original entrance to the old North Rock 6 movie theater, which opened in 1987 and closed its doors in 2003. In the late 90s, there was a push to expand the theater to compete with the other theaters that were, you know, opening around, like the Warrens and stuff. But that got pushed down, and the company, Dickinson Theaters, actually opened right behind it a bigger theater, the North Rock 14, which opened in 1998. So for a while, there were two different theaters that were operating in the same area, which is kind of interesting. But the North Rock 6 eventually failed, and it closed, and it got converted into office spaces, and the outside and inside were completely renovated. The building does look a little different. They added a second story, and the North Rock 14 eventually closed about a decade later in 2012, and it sat dormant for a few years until just recently this year, AMC Theaters bought it and turned it into the AMC North Rock 14. So next up on the list, we're at 320 North Rock Road, and right behind me is the site of the Cinemas East 6 Theater. It opened in 1974 and closed in the year 2000. And the theater was really just this part of the building. The outside's been renovated, and it's been resurfaced, refaced, so it's it looks a little different, but the bicycle peddler is still there, and that kind of helps keep a reference, but it was in that building back there. And after it was a theater, it was like this fitness place. It was like all ladies fitness or something. It was, I guess it was just a women's fitness place for a while. So we're at the Townie Square Shopping Mall right now. And about right here in this part of the building housed Cinemas 1 and 2, which were inside the mall. Those opened in 1976, just a year after the whole mall opened. And They did open a few other screens in a separate building that was further this way in the parking lot, and those opened in 1981 and stayed open past this one. This one closed in 2000, and those stayed on a little later than that, and they were eventually demolished. So across the street from the Townie Mall, in this very busy section of Wichita, right here about where the Holiday Inn was, before there was anything out here in 1948, there was the 54 Drive-In, and it stayed open until the early 1970s, and it was eventually demolished in 1973. But it's hard to imagine that a drive-in would be here given how busy it is out here, but you know, back then there was hardly anything out here, I guess. So we're here at the Morningstar Church, and it might look a little funky because might look a little bit like a movie theater, but that's because it was. It was the Palace East. It opened in 1991, and it ran until 2007. And the Palace was kind of cool. It was a discount theater, which means that after new movies would have their main theatrical run in the big theaters, it would come here and be cheaper. So you could see it if you didn't get a chance to see it at the more expensive theaters when it had its theatrical run. So that was pretty cool. But what I really like about this one is that they didn't change the outside of the building much. I mean, they painted it a little bit, but the overall shape of the palace was still preserved, which I think is really neat. They didn't go out of their way to change it much. So we're here at the Harry Street Mall, and right behind me was where the Mall Cinemas was. It opened in 1970 and closed in 1999. From what I've heard and read on the internet, this was the premier Star Wars theater, so this is where the original three films were shown to the people of Wichita. So we're here at the historic Dunbar Theater on Cleveland Street, and it's amazing. It looks just like an old theater. It's kind of like a little time capsule. I'm really glad they never tore it down. It looks like there's some sort of push to revitalize it for future use, which would be amazing for, you know, showing old movies or having performances. There's a mural on the side over here that kind of showcases what the Dunbar was famous for. A lot of jazz stuff, which I think would have been really neat back in the day. So we're in College Hill right now, and we're at the site of where the Crest Theater would have been. It's sadly not here anymore. It was built in 1950, and it closed in 1989. It was sadly demolished in 97, which is really a shame because it was quite a pretty theater. I've tried to guess like where exactly the theater would have been, and it would have been probably about here in this parking lot. I just used the brick house in the back as a reference from the old pictures. Like I said, it really is a shame that it was destroyed with being such a pretty theater, and it was huge too. It would be really cool to see, but unfortunately it's not here, but that's what happens sometimes. So we're in downtown Wichita right now. We're on East Douglas Street, and right behind me is where the Marple Theater used to be, and it's kind of remarkable. It still looks like a theater. It's got the marquee and everything. It's got the little light box where the poster would have been. It's really neat to be able to see that all preserved and everything. But it was built in 1908 as the Marple Theater. It changed its name in the 50s. It became the State Theater. And then in the 60s and 70s, things went a little downhill, and it became a porn theater called the Vogue Art. And then in 1977, it was a dinner theater, and then that closed after a while. It became a bar called Fat Tony's, and that closed as well eventually. So now it's just vacant and just sitting there waiting for something else to occupy. So I've been wanting to refrain from showing theaters that have already been demolished. I want people to be able to come out to these locations and find these old buildings for themselves. But this one, I think, really deserves a mention because of how big of a story it is, for one, and also how tragic it is, and some of the lessons we could learn from it. But right behind me, about right here, there was a theater called the Miller. It was right here where this parking garage is. And if you're familiar with the Orpheum, which is just down the street, it was basically its sister theater. It was built in 1922, and it really was just a work of art. The pictures don't really do it justice, but it's the best thing that we'll ever have now. But it eventually closed in 1970, and was destroyed upsettingly in 1972. Since then, I would say that there's this kind of community adoration for the Miller and what kind of theater it was, because there's been all sorts of exhibits at the Sedgwick County Museum about it here in Wichita. There was even a documentary made about the Miller a few years ago. It really kind of teaches us to be thankful for for still having the Orpheum, even, because these things don't last forever, and you never know when you know, something's going to get destroyed or demolished or closed, you know. So, you know, I think the Miller didn't really die in vain, but it's still kind of a dark spot and very upsetting and tragic how the story went down. So we're at the Grace Point Church off of West Central, and this building right here used to house the Cinemas West 4. It was opened in 1977, a pretty cool theater for its time, and it closed in 2002. It kind of laid dormant for a few years until they made it into the church right here. They renovated the outside of the building, so the exteriors look a little different, but it still kept its overall shape, so it's still pretty identifiable, I would say. So they didn't change it up too much. We're at the Twin Lake Shopping Center at 21st and Amadon, and right here behind me house the two Twin Lakes theaters. They were opened in 1968, and from what I hear, they were really nice theaters. They showed some pretty high-profile films like Stanley Kubrick's A Clockwork Orange and Francis Ford Coppola's The Conversation. And in 2014, they were eventually demolished. It's the only part of the building that was demolished, so go figure. Yeah, it's just kind of nice to ponder what could have been. So we're off of Ridge Road right now, at the ruins of the Palace West. You know, it's kind of weird seeing it like this. You know, I'll always have a soft spot for this theater because I went here quite a bit as a kid. And, you know, I went to the last showing when they announced that it was closing. And, you know, it was quite emotional because we all knew that it wasn't going to be here anymore. And they demolished it within like a few days. It was very hard to say goodbye, to say the least. But it was the oldest of the two palaces. It was built in the late 80s, and it was demolished not even a month ago in 2018. If there's anything to be learned from this, it's that nothing lasts forever, and that you just can't take stuff for granted, even something as trivial as a movie theater. You know, so just be thankful for everything that's around you, and just know that you never know when something's going to get demolished or closed. There's a rumor going around that once they clean this all up, that they're going to put a Cracker Barrel in here. That's just a rumor. It's not set in stone yet, so we'll just have to see when something like that happens, what they're going to do with that. But it's kind of a bummer, but that's what happens sometimes.